Hello students, today we are going to learn English class 6 3.7 at the science fair. Now fair means what? Fair means an exhibition. Science fair is very important in students' life. Why? Because the science fair is an important factor to motivate the students towards science. The science fair contributes their social developments. Science fair increases the skills of the presentation. Also increases the interest in being scientist and engineer. So let's start the chapter. Science fair at Vidyavardhini school was always an exciting affair. There were number of stalls, never less than 50, entertainment booths and of course refreshments. There were two basic rules. One, everything should be handled by students, and two, everything, even the entertainment booths and the refreshment stalls, had to have a scientific base. Now, there is a science fair where it is at Vidyavardhini school. Okay, booth means what? A small tent or a temporary structure at an exhibition, or we can say at an fair. Okay, it is called booth. Now, what two basic rules were followed in the science fair? The two basic rules were, everything was handled by the students, and second one, everything had a scientific base. Preparations for the fair began at least a couple of months in advance. The first step was brainstorming. The principal invited ideas for the event for students, teachers, and even parents. A host of ideas poured in. Luckily, many parents not only contributed ideas but also volunteered to help with the planning and implementation of big event. So, a committee of parents and teachers was set up to look after all the work of the fair. Some student representatives were also taken on the committee to give them a first-hand experience of managing big programs like this. Now, here, host of ideas means what? A large number of ideas. Okay, brainstorming, a group of people thinking of something at the same time to come up with the ideas and the plans. So the first step was brainstorming, and principal invited the ideas not only from the students or the teachers but from the parents also. And parents also, what they did, parents not only contributed their ideas but also volunteered to help the planning and implementation of this program, of this science fair. Okay, now the committee identified certain themes for the fair. They were plants, animals, properties of substances, energy, forms of energy and energy resources, science in our everyday life, latest news from the world of science, and food and nutrition. Considering the area of the playground, school playground, and the estimate turnout, it was decided to allow 56 stalls in the fair. The stalls were allotted to as many groups of children. Each group selected a topic idea from the chosen themes. The committee had to make sure that the topics were not repeated. Now here you can see there is a meeting of students, parents, well, and teachers. Okay, and how was the committee formed? Many parents not only contributed ideas but also voluntarily helped with the planning and implementation of the fair. So the committee of teachers and interested parents was set up to look after all the work of the fair. Okay, and also some student representatives were also included in the committee. Okay, and what themes did the committee identify? The committee identified the themes like here it is given plants, animals, properties of substances, energy, form of energy and energy resources, science in our everyday life, latest news from the world of science and food and nutrition. Now in this way they set up the committee and also given the themes to the students. Okay, and the committee had make sure that the topics were not repeated. Okay, and those topics and ideas should be chosen from the given themes. Okay, here it is given. The young scientists began their work in earnest. They began by collecting a lot of information about their topic using their science textbook, their school library, and also the internet. They shared and discussed this information in their groups. The next step was to decide the exact activity for their stall, whether they would build and display the model or give a demonstration or present their project through poster or simply exhibit the collection. So here the students prepare their stalls. Okay, and how did the students prepare stalls and how they present them? The students prepare their stalls in earnest. They began here earnest means what? Seriously. Okay, they start doing their work seriously. Now the students they began to collect a lot of information about their topic using their science textbook, also their school library and the internet. Also they shared and discussed this information in their groups. Then they decided the exact activity for their stall, whether they will build a build and display a model or give a demonstration, present their project through the posters or simply exhibit a collection. Okay, so the here the principal announced that the language, appearance and the content of the presentation were all important. The language teachers helped the young stall holders to make their graphic and oral presentation more effective. Now here graphic presentation is also given. See graphic presentation. Write to the point so that a visitor may read a chart or a poster at a glance. Make use of bullet points or the bullet list. Use pictograms, graphs, pie charts, etc. to show numerical data. Use pictures and diagrams and label them. Plan all your poster charts properly before you start making them. Make a rough mini copy before you begin work on the big final poster on chart. Don't forget to check your spellings, sentences or other errors in the mini copy itself. Use different colors to highlight important features, but use them judiciously. If you have used any text, pictures, diagrams, etc. from elsewhere, acknowledge the source. Okay, your oral presentation. The oral presentations or speeches should be short and to the point, 2 to 3 minutes at most. They should be directly related to the model demonstration or the specimen exhibited in the stall. Be confident when you make a presentation. Rehearse the speech well. Rehearse means what? Means practice the speech well. Be ready to answer the relevant questions. Practice doing that with your friends. So these are the points of oral presentation. Here also given, make use of the visual or graphic in the stall. Point to the relevant parts when you speak. Wear clean and tidy clothes, but do not dress up to show off. Be polite, be pleasant when you talk to the visitors. If you don't know the answer to the question, say so. But later on, try to find the answer. Smile. So these are the different steps for presenting the any model or any what we can say in the science fair. Okay, model or a chart presentation of the charts, made presentation of the model or collection of any information topics. Okay. Now, at last the big day arrived. The fair was inaugurated by the oldest science teacher, Mr. Ghizari. It was Mr. Ghizari who had come up with the idea of science fair some 25 years ago. Initially, it was meant for just one class, but the idea had become so popular that now the entire school participated in it. Mr. Ghizari explained the importance of using the science method to find the answers to the questions relating to the physical world around us. He was happy to see the stalls, especially the ones that showed simple method of identifying food adulteration. He appreciated the fact that in the most of the stalls, visitors could also try out the various science experiments and the models. He gave a special pat on the back to the clean brigade. The brigade members made round of the fear spreading the message of cleanliness, but that was not all. They had vowed to keep the school premises spick and span during fair. Though they expected more than 1,000 visitors and half as many stallholders, they were a disciplined lot. But what with so many activities and experiments going on, it was bound to create a lot of litter. They were well equipped with a garbage can, then scoops, brooms and wipes. Okay, now here you can see that the Mr. Ghizari. Here, who was Mr. Ghizari? Mr. Ghizari was the oldest science teacher, and it was Mr. Ghizari who had come up with the idea of science fair some 25 years ago. Okay. And what did Mr. Ghizari appreciate the most? Mr. Ghizari appreciated the fact that in most of the stalls, visitors could also try out the various science experiments and models. Okay. And the here clean brigade members made a rounds of the fear spreading the message of cleanliness. They had vowed to keep the school premises clean, neat, span during the fair. Okay. And they were well equipped to do this with the garbage cans, scoop brooms and wipes. Now here you can see the picture of fair, different stalls. You can see numbers also given, A12, A13, A11, like this, plants, animals. Okay, whatever themes are given, according to that students, they have prepared their models. Okay, and experiments, here it is given, and you can see the team of these teachers, principal, also the this oldest science teacher, that is Mr. Ghizari. You can see here. Now let us also take a round of the fair. Now the here we can see the children. See, the first step in the participating in a science fair is to come up with an idea. Children will have the opportunity to choose the topic. Okay, they are curious about the plans. Here you can see they are curious about plan and experiment that will help answer their questions and conduct an experiment. Correct. So here we can see now children, we are going to visit the science fair. This is the science fair. Okay, and take a round of different fair to see some highlights. Highlights are given here. The 6th standard children were handling the following stalls. Here some stalls are mentioned. Okay, from the fair. Okay, use of kinetic energy. The stall display the model of watery meal. Here you can see the picture. Next one is the sound. Everyone enjoy making simple string telephones at this stall and then using them. Food adulteration. Even the parents learn something at this stall. Next one is the use of potential energy. The plastic bottle, motorboat. You can see here electrostatic energy. This stall was so popular that additional help was needed to blow balloons as quickly as they were used up. Okay. Now fun with magnet. Visitors queue up to see the different types of magnets at work. Maintaining machines. Some of the visitors made video clip of the presentation at this stall. It consisted of different children playing the role of different machines, all crying out turn by turn, "Hey, we too need your attention. We can serve you well only if you take care of us." Okay. The fair was such a huge success that the school had to run it for 3 days instead of two. Okay. It was very successful fair. Okay. Exhibition science fair was very successful. That's why principal has given permission, allow to change the time. That timetable means first it was only 2 days. Now instead of 2 days, it was now 3 days. One day has given more extra. Okay. For this fair. And the principal allowed this change in the timetable only because it was a truly educational activity, not just for the children but also for their family and the entire community. No wonder everyone is already looking forward to the next year's fair. Okay, in this way, this fair was very nice, very successful because it was a truly educational activity. Okay. Now here the scientific methods are given. Observe what is around you, ask question why not, how, etc. Why does a fridge magnet stick to the fridge door but not to the kitchen platform? Can you think of an explanation? This is what is called hypothesis in the scientific method. Maybe it has some special powers. Set up an experiment to try out your hypothesis. I will try to stick it to different things, a wall, a tile, a potato, a wooden table, pots and pans, a plastic bottle, a cup. Now next, record your observations in detail. This is your data. The magnet sticks to some surfaces but not to others. Draw the conclusion. Do they match your hypothesis? If yes, why? If not, why not? It seems as if some metal objects are attracted to the magnet. They are made up of iron or steel. Write down your findings and share them with others. Magnet attracts iron but not all substances, not even all metals. Okay, students. So, in this way, this is the science fair. These are the different stalls. Here you can see the science fair in this picture. Okay. Oral presentation also we studied. Graphic presentation. Then, this is the committee before starting the implementation of the science fair. Okay. So, science fair is an opportunity for students to apply the scientific method to conduct independent research. The result of each student's research is presented in a school-wide science fair. Okay, so science fair is the we can say it is a competitive event hosted by schools. Okay, students. Hope you understood this lesson. Take care. Stay safe.